Go to college, graduate, work a job for 4 years, contribute to your 401k, and retire when you're 65 and too old to enjoy. That's the path we're told to follow, but it's not what we have to do. Believe it or not, you can actually retire in a much shorter time period than 40 years. It's not taught in schools, by your parents, or by society, but it is the truth. You can start today with nothing and retire in 10 years. And after that 10-year period, you can have freedom of money and time to spend however you like, doing whatever you want, not having to worry about working for someone else or doing things you don't want to do. Before we get into it, it's important to know that in order to make this happen, there will need to be sacrifices made on your part. You'll have to be extremely disciplined. This is not an easy task, and anyone who says it is absolutely lying. It's not for everyone, and it's going to take a lot of hard work, but it is possible, and in this video, I'm going to explain exactly how this can be done. The first thing you will need to do is to figure out the exact amount of money you need to save in order to be financially free. A lot of people have never thought about this number, but believe it or not, it's pretty simple to come up with. For this, we'll use two rules promoted within the FIRE movement. If you're not familiar, FIRE stands for Financially Independent, Retire Early. It's a large community of individuals who want to do just that, reach financial independence and retire early. So the two rules we are going to use to determine the amount you need save in order to retire are the 25x rule and the 4% rule. It works by estimating the annual income you expect you'll need when you are retired and multiplying that number by 25. Let's say for simple math that you need $50,000 in income to live once retired. Then you would multiply that number by 25 and you'd get $1.25 million. The 4% rule states that every year, once you hit that financial freedom number, you can pull out 4% of the money saved and it's gonna last you 30 years. So in this example, you'd be able to take out $50,000 every year from the total $1.25 million you saved, and it would last you 30 years. This accounts for historical market and inflation data and assumes you have the money saved in two assets, large cap domestic stocks and intermediate term treasuries. A lot of you guys might be thinking, if I'm going to retire in 10 years, I will need more than 30 years post-retirement. Don't worry, I'm going to talk about how you can make the money last longer than 30 years later in this video. One of the best things you can do to retire early is to invest in real estate because of its compounding long-term appreciation. It's what a majority of the super wealthy invest their money into, and that's why I'm so excited to talk about Fundrise, an easy-to-use platform for investing into long-term real estate that can diversify your portfolio and increase your passive income. Whether you have $10, $100, or $10,000 or more to invest, Fundrise allows you to start generating higher and more consistent returns than the stock market. Fundrise is making this possible through putting your investments into private real estate assets that have low volatility and significant long-term potential. Just take a look at their track record on returns for anyone that's ever invested with Fundrise. Now, historically, these types of investments have only been available to high net worth individuals and institutions. So it's really great that Fundrise is making private real estate investing open to anyone. Plus, all their deals are vetted by their team of expert underwriters. You guys can use my link, fundrise.com/CharlieChang, to start investing in real estate with Fundrise. And the link will be in the description. Again, use my link below to start investing in the best investment vehicle in the world. And now back to the video. But first, we need to assess your current financial situation in order to put a plan together to reach your financial freedom number. There are three main components: income, expenses, and savings. What I want you guys to do is to work with me while I go through an example and take your own situation into account. We're gonna use the equation income minus expenses equals savings. Let's say for the sake of easy numbers, your monthly income is $5,000 per month and your monthly expenses are $2,500 per month. In this scenario, you'd have $2,500 extra per month in savings. Next, you need to determine your ideal time frame for retirement. So in this video, we are focusing on how you can retire in 10 years. So let's use the time frame of 10 years. Keep in mind your financial freedom number. Now multiply your monthly savings number by 12 for the number of months in a year, and then by 10 for the number of years in your ideal retirement time frame. So we have $2,500 times 12 times 10 equals $300,000. You'll notice that this number is likely nowhere near your financial freedom number, but that's okay. We are going to discuss how you can make that number much larger, potentially even exceeding your financial freedom number within the 10-year period. Step one, eliminate unnecessary debt or expenses. If you're concerned that you're unable to save enough money with your current financial situation on a monthly basis, you are not alone. According to a recent study, nearly 2 out of every 3 Americans are living paycheck to paycheck since COVID hit. If this is you, you will need to make some adjustments in order to retire in the next 10 years. The first thing you will need to do is eliminate any high high interest debt. If you have credit card debt or personal loan balances that are making up a portion of your monthly expenses, you need to prioritize paying those off. Otherwise, they are going to continue to grow at high rates and cause this goal of retirement to never become reality. This step is only important for those of you with high interest debt. For the rest of you guys, listen to the next part. Next, you're gonna need to get rid of your unnecessary expenses. So think about all your monthly subscriptions you have, like Netflix and Spotify. For every $1 you spend on a monthly basis, you will need to add an extra $300 to your financial freedom number. This also works in the reverse. So for every $1 you can cut out of your monthly spending, you'll need $300 less saved up in order to retire. This is where the discipline comes into play. You will need to cut out things that you want to spend money on now in order to reach financial freedom and the ability to retire in 10 or less years. Guys, if it was easy to retire in 10 years, everyone would be done working and living on the beach or in the mountains by the age of 30. This is hard, but again, it really is possible. You need to minimize your expenses by cutting out unnecessary expenses. You need to actively work on making as much money as you can over the 10-year period through entrepreneurship, and put all your money after expenses into investments that will allow for passive income. This plan will only work over time with sacrifice, discipline, and consistency. I'm really confident that if you are able to follow these steps, you'll be financially free and able to retire in 10 years or less. So step two is to generate multiple income streams, and this is your active income. This is definitely more important than saving more money. So once you pay off your high interest debts and cut out unnecessary expenses, it's time to start working towards your financial freedom number. The way to fast track your savings is to start generating multiple streams of income. Relying on your full-time job alone will probably not allow you to reach retirement within the next 10 years. You'll need to start one or more side hustles in order to generate more income to put toward your financial freedom number, and then gradually going full-time into entrepreneurship. This is easier said than done, but this is how I've been able to make six figures per month. Personally, I think the easiest way to get started is by providing a service to people or businesses that aligns with your current skill set so that you don't have to go out and try to learn something completely new. Focus on what skills you have and what you're truly passionate about, because a side hustle will require a lot of work, but will make it much easier for you to reach your goal of retirement in 10 years. Think of it right now as being in this game where the main objective is to stash away as much cash as possible. Generate those multiple streams of income, and it's very likely that your overall income will go up significantly. If you guys do want to learn more about how you can get started, I'm going to link below my video about how to start a side hustle today. Step three is to focus on passive income. Remember how I said I would tell you how to make your financial freedom number last longer than 30 years? Well, here is how you do it. So once you have eliminated unnecessary debt and expenses and increase your income, you need to make your saved money work for you. You're gonna do this through passive income. By generating passive income streams, you'll be able to make more money on a monthly basis without trading your time for money. It's going to allow your savings to compound and will speed up the time to retirement. Now, the easiest way to generate passive income is through investing the cash you have into appreciating assets like stocks, cryptocurrencies, and real estate. Stocks are pretty easy to get into with apps like Robinhood and WeBull, which even offer free stocks for signing up. So yeah, I will put those links down below. And then if you wanna get into crypto, it's also simple to get into with apps like Coinbase and BlockFi, where you can get around 10% APY for holding cryptocurrencies in your account. And beyond investing, you can also build passive forms of business income. For example, creating one piece of content and having it continually generate money while you sleep. Or setting up a business where you have employees working for you so that you do not need to be present all the time. Anytime you have a leveraged business like that, the phenomenon of unattaching time from money becomes real, which opens up this new freedom that few get to experience. You guys, it's literally a form of working smarter and not harder. But yeah, when you combine this active income with this passive leveraged income, plus your investments, it's a recipe for success. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you liked the video, make sure to hit that like button and also subscribe to my channel for more videos just like this. I make a ton of content about personal finance, investing, and entrepreneurship. I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.